Hi all, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about one of the most common parameter in Pandas DataFrame, and that is an axis parameter. You will find this parameter in almost all the methods in Pandas DataFrame. So what is an axis parameter in Pandas DataFrame? It is an attribute that is used to access the group of rows and column labels of the given data frame. There are two types of the axis in Pandas DataFrame. When you mention axis is equal to 0 or index in any method of Pandas data frame, it means the action will happen at row level for each and every column in the data frame. Whereas when you will mention axis is equal to 1 or columns in any method of the Pandas data frame, it means that the action will happen at column level for each and every row in the data frame. If you can see here, axis is equal to 0, it means we are referring to all the rows. The action will happen at the row level. Whereas axis is equal to 1, it means it will do something at column level, whereas all the rows will remain as it is. Let's say in the sum method of Pandas data frame, if we are going to mention axis is equal to 0, what message we are giving to Pandas sum method that keep all the columns as it is and do an action at row level. Whereas if we are going to mention axis is equal to 1, we are sending a message that all the rows will remain the same, but some of the action will happen at the column levels. Now let's do some examples and get more clarity how axis is equal to 0 or axis is equal to 1 play their role to get the desired output. Let's import the necessary libraries, pandas and numpy. We are going to use read_csv method to read superstore dataset. Let's use info method to see how many records are there. So there are 9994 records. There are 20 columns and you can see the data type here. Here is a snippet of the code which I am using to clean the column names. Let's use a head method to see how our data looks like. So you can see here the column names are more readable and you can see the top 5 records. Here I am using pandas pivot_table method to transform our data set. We will discuss about pivot_table method later on in the series when we will be talking about how we can transform the data set for the analysis purpose. Here I am using pivot_table method to transform our data set so that I can explain you how axis parameter works. So you can see here, this is how our data has been transformed, where subcategory has become our index and central, east, south and west are our columns. Now let's do our first example to understand axis is equal to 0 parameter. Let's say our objective is to find the sum of sales for each region in df_pivot dataset. So in df_pivot dataset, there are 17 subcategories and 4 regions, central, east, south and west. And we want to find out the sum of sales for each region. What we are going to do here? We are going to call the sum method on our data frame df_pivot. Now let's see the doc string axis. Axis for the function to be applied on. So when we will mention axis is equal to 0, the message axis is equal to 0 passing to the sum method that we have freeze all the columns and you have to apply the sum function at row level. So what it will do is it will take the sum of all rows for each and every column. Let's run the code and see that. So you can see here our columns are there, central, east, south and west. But it has taken the sum for all the rows for each and every column. So that is the critical point which you have to remember. Whenever we mention axis is equal to 0, it means that the action will happen at row level for whatever the method you are using. And our columns will remain intact. And the vice versa happen for axis is equal to 1. Now let's say our objective is to find the sum of sales for each subcategory. So what we are going to do here, we are going to call our data frame df_pivot and then call the sum method and then we are going to mention axis is equal to 1. Now you can see here we have got the desired output. We have got the sum of sales for each and every subcategory irrespective of columns. So axis is equal to 1 parameter passing a message to sum method that the action will be taken at column levels. And that is how you got the total sum of sales for each and every subcategory. So this is a very critical point, that where the action will happen. Whenever you mention x is equal to 0 with any method in Pandas data frame, it means the action of that particular method will happen at row level. Whereas when you mention x is equal to 1, it means for that particular method, some sort of the action will happen at column level. This is the point you have to remember whenever you are using the access parameter with any method in Pandas data frame. By this example, we come to an end of this session. In the next session, we are going to discuss how to create new variables in Pandas data frame. Till then, guys, take care and have a good day.